Hello, and welcome to this video where we will be identifying five biblical signs that confirm to us that we are at the end of the world. So, without further ado, let us head straight into the video. Jesus said, "As in the days of Sodom, so shall it be at the end of the world." And one of the chief sins of Sodom was homosexuality. It's a part of the sin that led to their destruction. And today, this abominable practice is being pushed everywhere. And I mean everywhere. It's in the films, all over the movies, it's in politics, it's in music, even in the church. And the goal is to brainwash today's society, especially the younger generation, into thinking that it's normal. And if you're not down with the program they are pushing, what do they say to you? You're homophobic. You're no different to being racist. You are practically shunned for speaking out against such an act. Many have even lost their jobs for speaking out against this. Why? Because they want to brainwash and bully you, especially the younger generation, into thinking it's normal. Well, I'll tell you this, no man by the grace of God can convince me that a man sticking his private parts up another man's bottom where all sorts of smelly waste and garbage is excreted is normal. And yes, I know it sounds crude, I know it sounds disgusting. Oh Grace, how can you utter such words? Well, because I want you all to realise that it is a sick, grotesque mental disorder that paves way for all sorts of illnesses and diseases. The Lord himself calls it an abomination. And the Apostle Paul himself describes those who partake in such acts as no better than brute beasts. And today, as spoken of in Jeremiah 51 verse 7, the nations are mad, drunken with the false teachings of Babylon, as they now say that what God has called an abomination is a good thing. And we are told, "Woe unto them that call evil good and good evil." And because this world has embraced such things, know for certain that certain destruction is right around the corner. When I was younger, one of my favourite songs was by Whitney Houston, and it was called "The Greatest Love of All." And I really used to like and try to sing that song. I would often find myself singing the chorus, and it goes like this. Learning to love yourself, it is the greatest love of all. I decided love. And I used to like that song till I realised that it was a song conjured up by Lucifer himself, because the Bible tells us, "Greater love have no man than this, than a man lay down his life for his friends." So we see that the mantra of that song is in direct opposition to the words of Christ. And anything that is rooted in opposition to Christ is from Satan, as he was a liar from the beginning. And today he has filled the world like never before into believing that it's all about self-love. It's all about loving yourself and doing whatever makes you happy. Well, friends, this is one of the great signs that confirm to us that we are in the last days. As the Apostle Paul writes, "This know also that in the last days perilous times shall come." So what's the subject of Paul's discourse here? It's the last days. Again, "know also that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy," and the list goes on. But note that the first thing Paul mentions is self-love, lovers of themselves. And we see this act of self-love being plastered all over social media on apps such as Instagram, or should I say Instascam, and YouTube, where the most privileged like to boast about self-love, their spending expenditure, their materialistic items, while their fellow brethren are suffering without food, starvation, shelter. All this is one of the sure signs that we are in the last days and why destruction lies at the door. For it is written, Go to now, ye rich men, weep and howl for your miseries that shall come upon you. Your riches are corrupted, and your garments are moth-eaten. Your gold and silver is cankered, and the rust of them shall be a witness against you, and shall eat your flesh as it were fire. Ye have reaped treasures together for the last days. The greed and selfishness which we see being promoted in the world today is again one of the sure signs that we are in the last days. Another great sign that confirms we are in the last days is the rise of false prophets and false Christs. When the disciples asked Christ for a sign of when the end of the world should come, the first thing Christ said to them on that mountain was, "Let no man deceive you." And he then proceeded to tell them that many false prophets shall arise and shall deceive many. And today it is a sure thing. So many different winds of doctrine, men claiming to be prophets, so many setting false dates pertaining to the end of the world, so many false Christs appearing in all different parts of the world, alongside many false prosperity preachers preaching a false gospel, sadly leading many to the gates of hell. This is why the Lord tells us, "Cursed if you make man your flesh." We need to learn to study the Bible for ourselves, for as we see this intensify in this present age, it is all added confirmation that we are in the last days, and Satan is soon to appear to the masses as an angel of light to lead many to destruction. In Revelation 13 and in many other parts of the Bible, a remarkable prophecy is given regarding the rise and return of the papal church power. You see, a few centuries ago, the Roman Catholic Church practically ruled the world, and if anyone spoke up against this power and its evil ways, you were literally tortured and put to death. History estimates over 50 million families lost their lives to the charge of heresy during the Dark Ages. However, it was not until 1798 this power suffered a mighty blow under Napoleon's general Berthier, who took the Pope captive, where he was to later die in exile. It is here the Bible describes Rome as suffering a deadly wound. However, it was not to end there, as it tells us in Revelation 13 the deadly wound will be healed and Rome will regain its power back through the help of the lamb-like beast, which is symbolized as America. And today, we see this prophecy fulfilled to the very letter. Stealthily, unrecognized by many, the Roman Catholic Church is regaining its lost supremacy and is now pushing for the new one world religion and one world order, which it wants to be head of. And as we see these things happening right before our eyes, it's one of the sure, main and major signs that confirm to us that heaven is at the door. And the time is coming, and now is, that when you speak up against this false, wicked system and reject its false Sabbath rest, which falls on the Sunday, which is its mark of authority, you will be persecuted and you will need to flee to the most desolate places. This may sound strange to some of you all out there, but trust me, it will happen. The rise of the papacy, one of the sure signs we are commanded to look out for, and confirms once again that we are at the end. And last but not least is the sign, or should I say signs, given to us in Luke, which involve the earthquakes, the rumours of wars, the famines and fearful sights, which is set to intensify as we lead on to the great crisis, where man will have to take their stand for Christ or for Satan. The nations are unsettled. Oftentimes we hear the talks of wars, rumours of wars. We see the powers striving for supremacy. We see the strange earthquakes in diverse places. We see the tsunamis, floods, fire, a whole country practically in ruins following the storms that hit the Caribbean islands in 2017. All this confirms that we are at the end of the world and we need to get ready.